हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ चैप्टर 5। द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द टर्म यूज्ड व्हेन अ क्लाइंट लर्न्स टू बिहेव इन अ सर्टन वे बाय ऑब्जर्विंग द बिहेवियर of a role model or the therapist. The answer is modeling is the procedure wherein the client learns to behave in a certain way by observing the behavior of a role model or the therapist who initially acts as the role model. Okay? The next question is, when a child is given a coupon to buy something from the school canteen for punctuality, it is a form of A, aversive conditioning, B, token economy, C, modeling, D, inhibition. The answer is B, token economy. Next, the client-centered therapy was given by - A. Albert Ellis, B. Carl Rogers, C. Sigmund Freud, D. Frederick Perls. The answer is Carl Rogers. Next question, the most popular therapy which combines cognitive therapy with behavioral technique is, the option is A, biomedical therapy, B, gestalt therapy, C, client-centered therapy, D, cognitive behavior therapy. The answer is cognitive behavior therapy. Next question, state two psychological disorders in which cognitive behavior therapy is used for treatment. The answer is psychological disorders such as anxiety, depression, panic attacks, and borderline personality are treated with the help of cognitive behavior therapy. Okay. The next question is, what is the meaning of logotherapy? What is the meaning of logotherapy? The answer is logos is the Greek word. Logos is the Greek word for soul, and logotherapy means treatment for the soul. Viktor Frankl, a psychiatric and neurologist, propounded the logotherapy. Okay. The next question is, state four characteristics for psychotherapeutic approaches. The answer is, first, number one, there is systematic application of principles underlying the different theories of therapy. Next point, persons who have received practical training under expert supervision can practice psychotherapy, and not everybody. An untrained person may unintentionally cause more harm than any good. Next point, the therapeutic situation involves a therapist and a client who seeks and receives help for her or his emotional problem. That is, this person is the focus of attention in the therapeutic process. And next point, the interaction of these two persons, the therapist and the client, results in the consolidation, formation of therapeutic relationship. Okay. The next question is, what is occupational therapy? What is occupational therapy? The answer is, in occupational therapy, patients are taught skills such as candle making, paper bag making, and weaving to help them to form a work discipline. The next question, how is empathy different from sympathy? How is empathy different from sympathy? The answer is, in sympathy, one has compassion and pity towards the suffering of another, but is not able to feel like the other person. Okay? Not able to feel like the other person. On the other hand, empathy is present when one is able to understand the plight of another person and feel like the other person. It means understanding things from the other person's perspectives, that is putting oneself in the other person's shoes. Empathy enriches the therapeutic relationship and transforms it into a healing relationship. Okay. Next question, explain the concept of unconditional positive regard. The answer is, unconditional positive regard is the relation that the therapist shows towards the client during treatment. The therapist conveys by her or his words and behaviors that she or he is not judging the client and will continue to show the same positive feeling towards the client even if the client is rude or confides all the wrong things that she or he may have done or thought about. The therapist encourages this by being accepting, empathic, genuine and warm to the client. Okay, students? That's all. Thank you.